And now the news. Premier and Minister of Finance Dr. D'Orlando Smith presented the 2016 budget address on Monday, February 8th in the House of Assembly. Outlining his vision for moving the Virgin Islands towards self-sustainability, Premier Smith stated that the budget is a continuation of the last few years as the territory continues along the path of economic growth. The budget projects some $330.8 million in revenues, with recurrent expenditure in the region of $286.5 million, with the resulting recurrent surplus of $29.3 million that is expected to meet debt service obligations on existing loans to the amount of $12.4 million.
We will fund much of the development projects from loans that we have approved over the last two preceding years, in addition to some funding from the Consolidated Fund, to the amount of some $21 million and $20,550,000 respectively. This will do while contributing another $15 million to the reserve funds.
The Premier also disclosed plans to augment decades-old fees and taxes. He said the measures are expected to yield up to some $20.5 million in additional revenue in 2016.
This year is but the first of a four-year term. Therefore, Madam Speaker, in view of the relative levels of taxes and fees that we now pay, some of which have remained at the same levels for the last several decades, we have, after much contemplation and assessment, decided to augment the following fees and taxes in 2016 as follows. One, change the current work permit structure such that the fees will reflect improvements in efficiencies of the Labor Department and be more aligned with fees charged in other overseas territories. Two, reverse the charging of import duties on the FOB rather than the CIF value. Three, change water rates to be more closely aligned with the cost of purchasing and distributing water. Four, continue a more aggressive approach to the collection of current taxes and fees and arrears by reviewing current legislation to give revenue collecting agencies greater authority to enforce compliance. These measures and others that I have not mentioned here, but will expound on in another forum, cause us to expect to yield up to some $20.5 million in additional revenue in 2016. In addition to the measures instituted in 2016, in 2017, we expect to adopt a more modern progressive payroll tax system to promote equity while maintaining the simplicity of the current tax structure. We will introduce innovations to tax collection methods, thereby improving efficiency and reducing the costs associated with the collections. And we will review and revise the current stamp duty regime. Our expectations are that in combination with the measures taken, we are projecting total additional revenue of some $26.2 million.
Other notable policy changes in the 2016 budget presentation include steps to boost the financial services sector locally and in international markets, expansion within the Department of Trade to focus on investment promotion through local and inward investments, an advancement toward what he described as the long overdue consumer protection platform in the Virgin Islands, among other areas.